Good morning, children. Today's subject is science. Today we are going to see the next part of lesson number 11, that is work and energy. In last period, we started the lesson number 11, work and energy. In that, we have studied about the some actions in which there is a work is done. When the work is done, when an object is displaced, by applying a force, we can say that work is done. Okay, and some examples also we have seen in last period. Now today we again so many examples we have to see. So let's start the next part. Now everyone see in your textbook page number 77, here one picture they shown of using a pulley. As in a village, as you observe, their wells are there for taking the water. So to remove the water from well, they are having a pulley wheel like structure. On that thread is there, so and at one end they tie the bucket, and with the help of that pulley we can remove the water from a well. Same thing here, having the pulley, but here now in place of bucket they are fixing the weight, they are attaching the weight. So according to that we have to observe how much work is done. See, when the applied force is same, more work is done. When there is a greater displacement, as the distance is more, see, as the distance is more, work done also more. So in other words, for measuring the work, both the force and displacement must be considered. For studying the work, the two important thing is necessary, which two things? Force and displacement. So these two things are very important to study the force. Okay, now the next part, relationship between work and energy. So now we have to see the what is the relation between work and energy. Now see here one example. The boy in the picture has applied a force to a toy car as he is playing a car. So he is applying a force to that toy car. So what happened? As the boy applying the force, the car get displaced. The car get displaced means what? The car change their position, change their place. And so what we can say here, work has done. We can say that work has done. How that work has done? As here transformation of boy's energy. As that boy is there, he have their own energy. So as he apply the force, so what will happen? There is a transformation of boy's energy into work. Means there is a transformation of energy through that boy to that car. And as he transforms the energy in the form of force, so the car get displaced. And as the car get displaced, work has to be done. Now see another one example. Now with your friends, you can run around a ground. Okay, so is it possible, can your friend run as many round as you can? Yes, is it possible you and your friends can run in a same speed and in a same number of rounds? Yes, is it possible? No, because everyone's capacity is different. No, yes, because all your friends or whatever maybe your friends are there, he not have the same capacity like you. So your friends will complete either more or less rounds than the number of rounds you complete. It may be less or more, then their numbers will not be same. Some will get tired on completing two rounds only. Immediately within a one round or two round, some will get tired. Then while others will get tired on completing 3 to 4 rounds. Means that is to say that each one's capacity to complete a round is not the same. So you can complete only as many rounds you have your own capacity. How much you have capacity, that much only you can complete the round. Means what? The capacity to do work is called energy. How much we have capacity, that capacity is called to do work is called energy. So what is the definition of energy? The capacity to do work is called energy. Understood everyone? Now see some question, use your brain power. The first question is, why do we get hungry after physical exercise? as we are doing the physical exercise means there is a movement of muscles and bones, means we are using the legs, hand, yes, so they are having the exercise. So for that we need the energy. For doing exercise we need the energy. As energy is supplied by the body, as energy is utilized from the body, and we get the energy from food, yes or no, we get the energy from food. So as we utilize the energy, we feel more hungry. As we utilize the energy for exercise, we feel hungry. Okay, so after exercising we feel hungry. Understood everyone? Now the second question, from where does our body get energy? From where does our body get energy? Our body get energy only through the food that we consume, means through food only we get energy. Okay, third question, why do we get tired? Yes, why do we get tired? As we do the excessive work, when we do the excessive work, then whatever may be the stored energy is there in our body, that all stored energy is utilized. Yes, so then we our energy is the stored energy in the body becomes low. The stored energy in the body becomes low, so we feel tired. So we get tired. Understood everyone? Now do you know? See, the unit of work and energy are the same. The unit of work and energy are same. The work and energy both are measured in unit, that is joule. In SI unit, it is called the joule. J-O-U-L-E is the unit for work and energy. For both work and energy, the unit is same. That is joule. Okay. The next part is forms of energy. Okay. Means types of energy we have to see. The first form is mechanical energy. First form is mechanical energy. So now observe the picture. Here rubber band is there and one game is there. We are using that stretching a rubber and holding the stone. See what will happen as a result of action in the picture. The rubber band is released after stretching it. First we have to stretch it and then release. What will happen? The rubber comes to their original position, original state. Now second one, a stone is held in the rubber of a catapult. That name of the game is catapult. Okay, holding, stretching the rubber and holding the stone in that and are releasing it. So that game is called the catapult. So what will happen? The stone is held in the rubber of a catapult. The rubber is stretched and released. What will happen? The stone will move forward. Stone will move forward and that rubber band or rubber is comes to their original position. Yes. So in this example we see that when the rubber of a catapult is stretched and released, it comes back to original state and the stone flies off. Yes, the stone flies off means it will move forward. Similarly, when the spring of a toy, different toys are there now having the spring, when the spring of a toy is wound and then released, the toy starts playing. When water stored at a height is made to fall on a wheel, the wheel start rotating. In each of these action, displacement takes place. Yes, there is a movement of the object. Displacement takes place, which means that work is done. As they are having the displacement, which means that work is done. From where is the energy obtained to do this work? Yes, from where get the energy to do the work. The energy which is stored in an object due to specific state or position of that object is called potential energy. So here which type of energy is there? Potential energy. Potential means stored energy. So when we stretch that rubber band, so whatever may be the energy in our body, it is stored in that rubber. It is stored in that rubber. And again, when we rotate the key of a toy, yes, when we wound it, so whatever may be the in our body energy is there, it is stored in that key or spring. In the spring, that energy is stored. So that is the potential energy. Now when the water what will happen when water, the stored water, when water stored at a height, okay, the stored water, in the stored also, in stored water also one type of energy. Which energy in the stored water having? Potential energy. Understood the meaning of potential means? Potential energy means what? The energy which is stored in an object due to specific state or position of that object. Means it is stored in an object. This type of energy is called the potential energy. Now let's see again examples. Now see again one example. Take a two ball. Take two balls. Let one of them stand stable at the center of the table. We have to take one table and on that we have to take a two balls. At the center it stand stable. Okay. Now place the second ball on the table and push it. Now here yellow color and red color is there. So now red color ball is the first one and yellow is the second one. So now we have to push it. To which ball? Yellow ball. We have to push it so that it hits to the first ball. As we push to the yellow ball, it hits to the red ball. And yes, so it hits to the first ball. So what will happen? What happen when the second ball hits to the first one? So what happened when the second ball hits to first one? The first one ball will move. And the second one ball reached to the first ball position. See, observe in the picture. At first, where the red ball? At this place, the first yellow ball will come. And now, the red ball will move in other direction. So, now another question is what? From where did the second ball get energy? Yes, from where did the second ball get energy? As we push the second ball, so from our body, the energy is transferred in the yellow ball. Yes, from our body, the energy is transferred to the yellow ball. And when we hit to the red ball, from the energy from yellow ball is transferred in a red ball. The energy from yellow ball is transferred in a red ball, and so the red ball displaced. So the red ball get displaced. Yes or no? Yes. So here having the displacement. As here displacement is there, work has to be done. Yes or no? Now see, can you tell in the game of marbles, from where does one marble get energy to set another marble in motion? In marble, we are using the fingers. Yes, from finger we hit the marble. So means from our body through the finger, the energy is transferred in the marble. And so it get displaced. Yes or no? Then again, in another one game, carom board also. While we playing the carom, we hit to striker. Yes, we apply the force to striker. So the striker get energy. And as through the striker get energy, it will hit to the pieces of coins. And so it will get move. Yes or no? So here we apply the force. So from our finger, the energy is transferred in that striker. And from the striker, it transferred to that coins. Yes. So we give energy to the marble or the striker and set them in motion. As we applying the energy, as we applying the force, so it set in a motion. The energy obtained from motion is called kinetic energy. And this type of energy is called the kinetic energy. As the after applying the force, the object gets start to move. The object is in a motion, then that type of motion is called the kinetic energy. The energy obtained from motion is called kinetic energy. Now the energy used for doing mechanical work is called mechanical energy. The energy used for doing mechanical work, whatever the mechanical work is there, for doing that, which energy is used, that is called the mechanical energy. There are two types of mechanical energy, that is potential energy and kinetic energy. Potential energy and kinetic energy. Potential energy is obtained due to the position and kinetic energy is due to the motion. So these are the first form of energy, mechanical energy. And again, mechanical energy is divided into two types, that is potential energy and kinetic energy. Understood everyone up till now? Okay. So now the next part we have to see in a next video.